So up on the lift today is a Hyundai Kona Electric, and I'm just fitting some new tyres to this vehicle. So this car currently has Uniroyal tyres fitted with shark skin technology. What a load of marketing rubbish that is. But anyway, these tyres are down to the wear indicators on the front and nearly the same on the back, and this car's having an MOT later this month, so these tyres need changing. And the customer asked me to get another set of Uniroyal tyres, and for no particular reason other than that's what was fitted on the car. But of course these aren't the original tyres that were fitted by Hyundai in the factory, and these tyres are 71 decibels, so while they're rated A for wet performance, on an EV they're quite a noisy tyre. So instead I'm fitting Goodyear efficiency grip performance, and in this size tyre these are 68 decibels and they're about the same price. And this is them, and in this size tyre it's rated B for efficiency and B for wet grip. Those Uniroyal tyres are actually C for efficiency and A for wet grip. And you can't have everything in a tyre, there's always some sort of compromise, and in this particular size you can't get an A and an A. So when it comes to buying tyres for an electric vehicle, obviously you've got to bear in mind the efficiency and the wet grip figures, or rating should I say, but in this case I thought it was more important to look at the decibel rating, the noise value, because this is 3 decibels less, and apparently 3 decibels is half the noise. So on an EV, because you've got no engine, they're very quiet, as I'm sure you all know, and all you can actually hear in an EV is the tyre noise. So going from a 71 decibel tyre to a 68 decibel tyre should make quite a considerable difference. So personally, for our own electric vehicles, my preference is an all-season tyre, and we are running the Goodyear all-season tyre on our Hyundai Ioniq. And that has the same decibel rating, 68 decibels. Obviously with an all-season tyre it's a bit of a compromise in the summer, but they're far better in the winter than running a summer tyre all year round, and obviously a lot cheaper and more convenient than running a summer tyre and a winter tyre. But I've got videos about those on the channel, I'll put a link to one at the top of the screen, but in this case the customer just wanted a standard summer tyre. So in this particular size, obviously it varies depending on the size of your tyre, but in this particular size and rating, these Goodyear efficiency grip seem to be about the best tyre available. So hopefully the customer will notice a difference with his new tyres in that they're 3 decibels quieter, and that should make a noticeable difference. The trouble is now we're in the middle of winter and we've had all these storms in the south of England and the roads are just flooded, so on a wet road it's probably not going to be noticeable, but come the spring when it's a lot drier and there isn't standing water on the road, then these should be noticeably different to those Uniroyals. So new tyres have different tread depths when they're new, and typically it's 7.4 or 7.5 millimetres. However, a lot of newer tyres, that is now reducing, and it can be 6.5 or less. So let's have a look at these. And this is actually 8.2. Yeah, 8.2 millimetres, so that's very impressive. So these should actually be pretty good in the wet weather we've currently got, and should expel water pretty well. So the last Goodyears I fitted were, they were less than 7 mil, I think, 6.8. So for a modern summer tyre, this is actually very good. However, I'm not sure whether softer compound, quicker wearing tyres have deeper tread depths, and a harder, longer lasting tyre has shallower tread depths, so they all wear about the same sort of time and last about the same sort of mileage. I'm not sure, I'm sort of guessing that's the case. I'm not a tyre expert, so I don't know, but for a modern summer tyre these have got pretty deep tread depths. So that will do for this one. If you found it useful, as always, please do click that thumbs up. That really does help. And do subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you on the next video.